Hello, welcome to the first episode of what I'm calling The Teenager Historian. Dumb name, but dumb videos. Today, we're going to talk about a country, or, well, specifically, two countries. Ukraine and Russia. They're at war, they're fighting. Now, let's talk about something, you know? I think this will be interesting. Now, well, first, let's answer something. What are they fighting for? What is Crimea? See this? This peninsula right here is very important. Probably the whole reason Russia makes an invasion in the first place. You see, this peninsula alone is in the middle of the Black Sea. It is strategically and economically very powerful. Let's go deeper in. What makes this so important? What makes this little piece of land so major? Let's go into the first chapter. What's going on right now? What's happening? You know, because right now it has been annexed by Russia, which was previously Ukrainian. Why does Russia want it? What's up with the history behind it and the culture? We'll explore. Let's start. So, let's start a bit on history. According to Britannica, some website I found, it was first occupation were by these people, the Kimmerians. Though other nations had conquered it, it still was very influenced by people like, Alexander the Great. And, well, what would happen then is it would next get under Roman control. You know, let's compare. As you can see, the Roman Empire is massive, but they don't have much of Crimea. They would swoop in, right? They would go for Crimea a bit, but they never had the full area of it. But it would still lead them to full control of the Black Sea. The Romans knew this was a desirable area, so that's why a lot of them came up here. Also against the Persian Empire, but I think Crimea was a big one too. So yeah, that's one big thing. Crimea was very important towards the Romans. They started going towards there, but they will never have enough time to fully have it due to distance and just how to carry this entire empire alone. They already have to deal with, Britain, which at the time is England. The next ones that would kind of have occupation and power over it was, the Ottomans. The Ottomans would have a lot of control over Crimea, and this was very important. Crimea becomes major. So basically, yeah, they have the Crimea. The Ottomans have control over it, but guess who is the next one to take it? Boom, bar bum 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 bum. It is the Crimean War. All right, just to explain things. So, Turkish War, right? It's 1768 to 1774. It's a big Russian win. They take Crimea, all thanks to this amazing queen, Queen Catherine, who I think is really awesome, you know? And she even destroyed Poland, so that's pretty cool. And another thing was the Crimean War, which I'll explain right now. This is the Treaty of Paris in 1856. That was the Crimean War. And basically creates neutral territory over the sea borders in the Black Sea. But I don't think it takes away Crimea in this, space-wide, no. And what I also know is they basically kicked them off from the Balkans because they're scared that Russia advances to the Balkans in this war. So that's based off what I know. So yeah, what happens is the Russian Empire absolutely dominates everything. They have massive power. The Russian Empire, I feel like, doesn't get talked enough because this is the third largest empire in the entire world. And Crimea is very important because Eastern Europe, or what should I say, Eastern Russia, this was major for them. These were where they would get access to stuff like the Black Sea, the Baltic Sea, so we already have a lot. One, strategic location. Two, huge desire over it against their enemies like the Ottomans. This is just something that the Russian Empire always wanted. They didn't like the Ottomans because, the Ottomans were not very different in religion and identity. and nationalism was getting very popular at this time. So yeah, this is basically what happens, and you know, it lasts forever. You know, the Russians grow enormously, everything is beautiful, and yeah, they get absolutely whooped by Germany, which Germany also gets absolutely whooped by the Allies. So, I wonder, who got absolutely destroyed more? Russia or Germany? Who cares, you know? So yeah, the Soviet Union, you know, comes in, and they still occupy Crimea. Very important. The thing about the Soviet Union was communist country, of course. And they start expanding far. Let's go see how they do. I think the USSR falls, which, yeah, you all know it does well. I don't know why I was trying to keep that like a secret or something. Yeah, so they expand this far. Look how much land that is, though. Like, seriously, these break away later on, but like, seriously, that's enormous. And look at this. So yeah, Russia, which is the USSR, is enormous power and spreads across the entire world with their communist ideals. The Cold War happens, you know, it's just freezing there. Makes sense why it's the Cold War. And the USSR slowly falls away. You know, slowly more and more countries fall off and just leave the USSR. This mainly happens, I believe, 1990 to 1991, and then fully gets destroyed probably like late 1991 to early 1992, somewhere there. And funny enough, Kazakhstan's the last one to be the USSR, only for 4 days. Not even Russia. How funny. So, as we have just established, Crimea, very important towards Russia. They've had it for like centuries. This is very important towards Russian culture and how Russia is. So, Ukraine now occupied it, right? They're mad. They want Ukraine, you know. They want Ukraine, you know, they want Kiev. Or is it Kiev? Kiev? I can't pronounce it right. But Crimea is even more important because, like, we already went through history, right? The history of it. Now let's go over a bit of economics. I don't know too much about the money it makes, but I do know this. It's in the middle of the Black Sea. Like, let me show you this. As you can see, a lot of wars started over this, right? The Black Sea was very important. This was the seas, and basically it would allow a lot of ports to be made. And since it went through Istanbul, right, as a canal, I believe, it would basically allow you to be able to get through and get to the other sea, right, to get through the seas. So that's why the Black Sea was so important. Look at Crimea. This is literally one of the best spots you can get for the Black Sea. Everyone wanted this. It's almost in the direct middle. This point right here, like, it's basically in the full middle. That's what made it so important. With, you know, Russia occupying it is very major. Why do you think they built about 3 full-on defenses on Crimea alone? It's so insane about how much they want to protect it. If the Crimean Peninsula falls and goes to Ukraine again, this might be the end for Russia's invasion. It's that important. Now, let's talk a bit about the culture. The thing about Crimea was that it represented something inside Russians. It was the importance of them. It made them feel like they were true warriors. They were able to conquer the Ottomans. They were able to bring back Orthodox Christians, which is something that they loved Orthodox. That was kind of the majority religion back then. They stood for that. And, well, the culture there kind of had a lot of promotion towards it. And, well, Crimea kind of just represents Russian superiority, Russian power. So that's why they really want it, too. This is literally something that Russia fought so hard and with so much blood for. They didn't want to give it up that easily. One more thing is that they don't really consider countries like Ukraine, Belarus, or the Baltics to be sovereign nations. They still consider them part of them, since there's so many Russians and they've always been together like that for a long time. We've established the history, we've established a lot of culture behind it, just how like close it is. You know, a lot of Russians are there, very ethnically, especially seeing how Ukrainians were Russians, right? Just 3 decades ago, you know? We've also established how economically powerful it is. And remember, Ukraine is also major because it has great farmland. Russia used to have some of the best farm areas like Ukraine, and maybe even Poland a bit. And I think maybe a bit of Belarus, but Ukraine mostly, right? They have the Dnieper River right here, but losing this stuff, you know, they want to take back all this stuff because like how major it is. Let's look how much they lost when it collapsed. If we can look here, because of the collapse of the USSR, Russia lost literally 23. So this is almost 25% of all of its territory, almost 50% of all the population, and 41% of the gross national product. So like, that's almost 50%. Imagine, like half of all of the money you could be making, gone. Half of your gross domestic product, you know? That's insane. 40% of the industrial potential and 44.6% of the military potential, gone. It's all gone. All of these resources went to the former Soviet republics. That is so much land and resources. That is insane amount. And remember, this might not be a lot. You could say, you know, they still have the rest of the 75. Well, guess what? Siberia sucks. The southern area is the most green areas there. It's just like some swamps and that's kind of it. It's not as great as anyone assumes. So yeah, they barely have any good areas left. They only have like Moscow, like the rivers, the Volga River. But this stuff, this is so major. And 50% of the population, you see what I mean there? Everyone lived there. Now they're no longer Russian. Russia does not have the military force they had a long time ago. It's kind of over for them at this point. Unless they can take Ukraine and, you know, maybe annex Belarus or even get the Baltics, which they're in NATO, so good luck with that. So unless they do stuff like that, it's kind of over for them, really. Like, I don't see how Russia can expand other than Kazakhstan. But we'll get to that in another episode. So I believe that's all I've got. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. Hope you learned something about Crimea. And yeah, I'll see you soon. The next episode, I want to explore something about maybe World War II or something, you know, like something to pull in the views. We'll get like a thumbnail of Hitler. And maybe something else. I'll see you later, and hope you had a good day.